Hey there, Leo. Welcome to your reading for the week of February 13th. Let's see what's going on for you. This week could be a good week for love, actually. Let's see what else comes up for you. Yeah, like I said, finally, this week, everybody's message has been different for once, which normally there's a lot of similarities between every sign. But you start off with the Two of Hearts, great card for love, especially if you're single, great card for trying to meet somebody new or actually meeting somebody who becomes very important to you. If you're already in love, this could be you matching up perfectly with a situation, you know, just meeting up with friends they haven't seen in a while, meeting up with, you know, people you haven't seen in a while, doing social things with people you haven't seen in a while, meeting up with your kids, you know, all sorts of stuff comes up under this card like that. It usually just represents happiness, a card that represents a situation, like going and doing something that makes you happy. So it's a very good card to have. It can even be a good job too. I mean, you know, if you maybe you get a job this week that makes you really happy with that card. So definitely happy to see that. Next, Three of Diamonds, double check all paperwork that you are involved in, especially involving anything legal. If you're signing any contracts or dealing with inheritances or anything. Legal, anything even remotely legal, double check all paperwork. This card represents problems with paperwork that'll come back to, you know, bite you in the future, so make sure to do that. A lot of the times also, if you're involved in any like legal battles or anything, you could even find something that benefits you in the paperwork, so make sure to take advantage of double checking all your paperwork this week. Next, you have the Nine of Spades, past disappointments and realizing how they were a blessing in disguise. Normally, I say that this card represents disappointments, but you have the Ace of Spades following it up, which always pretty much makes this card represent past things that have already happened that were maybe disappointing. And seeing how, like, now is a better time. So, like, maybe you couldn't do something in the past, but now you can do it this week, or maybe you can start to do it. You're seeing how you're going to be able to do something that you wanted to do, and you're also coming to the realization that it's better that you had to wait, even though you probably didn't want to. So definitely, it's actually a very good card to get when, you know, in that type of situation. Next, you have the Ace of Spades. Overcoming obstacles represents existing problems being resolved. Also a card of victory, like winning something probably very personal to you. These are like little personal victories in your life, and that are always very nice. They can, actually, it can be quite major victories as well, reaching certain levels of success, kind of like stepping up into something new in your life. A very good card to get. Also kind of like a death card, you know, can represent that type of transformation, transforming past some things in the past. And yeah, it's a very good card to have. Next, you have the Joker. A lot of you could be traveling this week, moving around a lot this week. Again, I always think the Joker to me is a very busy card. It's about being very busy and doing a lot of things. Also kind of like a card of mastery. Again, I feel like really the message for you is that this week you're feeling like you've reached a new level. So I mean, I don't really like feel the traditional meaning of this card. I feel like it's something different. Like I feel like you're just, a lot of you are kind of feeling different yourselves. I think a lot of you are feeling like you kind of have reached a whole new level, maybe in career for some of you, for some of you relationships, for some of you both, and maybe even other things in your life. But this is definitely a card of being busy. It's a good card though, because it allows you to handle the busyness. It allows you to handle all the stuff that you're going to have to do this week. And finally, you have the Four of Clubs. Double check everything that you do this week. This is a card that represents retrogrades in general. We have this Venus retrograde coming up. So definitely double check all, again, double check all paperwork. Double check everything that you do. But other than that, it's actually a good card of having your thoughts kind of calmed as well. So a lot of you could be having like your thoughts calmed in certain situations. Like maybe, you know, you're dealing with a situation with somebody in your life or your child or children, maybe multiple, or maybe you're in a relationship. And maybe over the past few months, I would say since probably October, you've been having some thought, like just thoughts about things, you know, the kind of like the hamster wheel in your head, wheels spinning, thinking about, you know, the what ifs maybe, or, you know, just what's happening in general. And I think that this week, this card could represent a certain calm, maybe some of your worries and ideas and thoughts just kind of leveling out and being more even. So I'd like to see that as well. But it looks like an interesting week, I'll say that. So thank you for watching and enjoy it.